Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2194, Wrapping Columns. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gell, and today's question sent in by Gwen. Gwen is watching video 984, which was called Snaking Columns. This is from years ago, and I actually used a formula to solve this back then, but this Gwen's problem is more complicated. So she has a three-column worksheet with around 15,000 rows, and needs to make each page six columns. So on the first page, these 60 cells, and then next to it, the next 60 cells. Now, Gwen has figured out that she can fit about 60 rows, but for anyone else watching this, the most important part here is to figure out how many rows, because you'll really screw things up if you make any of these changes after the fact. All right, so for me, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here to Page Layout. I'm going to declare that these seven columns are going to be my print area, set print area. I'm going to go into print titles and say that rows to repeat at top is 1:1. I'm going to go, actually I like to use margins here, margins narrow, and then back into page setup, header footer, and choose whatever my custom footer should be, confidential. Do all of those settings, anything you're ever going to change, first. Right, because that's going to change the number of rows per page. Now, I'm going to type in the number 1 here. This is just going to be some temporary data. I'm going to hold down the Ctrl key and grab the fill handle and go down until I'm sure I'm past the first page, like that. And then we'll just do a print preview, Ctrl P. Show print preview. And I'll notice that I have 46 rows that fit on the first page. And let's just check, go to the second page. So 46 plus 46 is 92. So we're getting 46 rows per page. 46 rows per page. That number is incredibly important. 46. In fact, I'm going to write it down over here just so that way I don't forget. 46 rows per page. All right, now I'm going to solve this today with a macro. Back in video 984, I used some complex formulas to do it, but today a macro feels better. If you've never used macros before, don't be intimidated. Here's how we start. We press Alt F11. Alt F11. That brings open this screen. And actually, the very first time that you open Alt F11, it's going to be just a big gray screen, probably a lot like this, like that. So you want to say View, Project Explorer, find your workbook here, and say Insert Module. Now, I've already done that, and what we'll get, is a white screen. And over here in this white screen, you're going to type this code, all right, the word sub, which means that this is a subroutine, and then any name you want. I call it wrap them, no spaces there, so just jam everything together, open and closing paren. Then we're going to create a variable, final row is equal to cells, open paren, rows.count, comma1.end, and these four letters here are XL, not X1. Everybody screws this up, XL, and you can type it in all caps if you want, but they're going to change it back to that format where the L looks like a 1. Don't put a 1 there. Rows per page, and this is where you put whatever number you figured out. Now, for me, it's 46. For Gwen, it sounds like it's 60. And then the next row where we want the first data to go is row 2. And then the next column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, is column 5. All right, so I set this up. And then the rest of this is going to be very, very generic. It's going to work with any size data set. For I, this is a variable, equals 2 to final row, that's how many rows we had. Step, that means every time through the loop, we're going to increase by rows per page, which in this case is 46. For Gwen's case, it's going to be 60. We're going to say cells, next row, so next row is going to be 2, column 5, dot resize, 46 rows, 3 columns, dot value is going to be equal to, and that's an underscore there, is going to be equal to cells I, so whatever is in row 2, comma 1, column 1, dot resize rows per page 3, dot value. All right. And then what we have to do is we have to be a little bit clever here about after we paste the first 46 times 46 rows by 3 columns, where do we go next? All right. So if currently the next column is pointing to column E, well then I need the next one to go to column I. I is the ninth column. All right, so that's why we say next column equals 9. But if we're not at next column equals 5, that means that we're at next column equals 9, then we're going to reset the next group back to column E, and the next row is going to be equal to whatever the previous row was, plus 46, and then next die. Now here, let's just walk through this. You don't have to run it one step at a time, but I'm going to do that with F8 just to see what we get here. And so what we've learned is the final row is row 15,582. We're about to write to row 2, column 5. And so for I equals 2 to final row, the first time through, I is going to be equal to 2. We're going to say that row 2, column 5 is going to be equal to row 2, column 1, 46 rows, 3 columns. And when I run this with F8, we'll look over here in the spreadsheet and we'll see that sure enough, those first 46 came to this area. All right, but we're going to let this run again. All right, now the second time through the loop, the I has jumped up from 2 to 48. All right, and so this time we're going to be writing to row 2, column 9. And we're going to be getting data from row 48. All right, now let's go check this one right here. So what we see is Andy Hartley, that works great. Down here at the end, Kelly Ferguson, but the next person should be Lou Rahman, and that works, and it goes down to Lou Harvey right there. All right, now what we're hoping next time is we get Barb Davison. All right, so I'll press F8 a few more times. Here's the next one. And we look, and it's now writing to row 48, right? And it's Barb Davison, and it appears to be working. At this point, I'm happy with it. I'm just going to click Run. And actually, you don't have to go, if you're not creating a video to explain this to somebody, you don't have to go through and press F8. You can just come up here, click inside, wrap them, click Run, and that fast, it will take your data and wrap it into two columns. Now, some things I see here. Surname isn't wide enough. That should not affect our page layout, I'm hoping. And when I do print preview, I now have 170 pages. Data there, page 2, page 3, page 4. Now, if we would change the margins at this point, everything is going to be screwed up. It's going to be horrible. That's why it's really, really important right up front. You have to do all of your page layout things before you calculate that 46. Now, of course, at this point, save the workbook with a new name, right? We don't want to destroy the original workbook, and then you can delete columns A through D, and you have your results. Now, if you want to learn about macros are incredibly powerful. We probably could have solved this with a formula, and certainly the me from 10 years ago solved it with a formula. But at this point in my life, just a simple little 15-line macro is a lot easier. This book by Tracy Sierstad and myself will teach you all about macros. All right, wrap up of this episode, how to wrap three columns of data in two sets of columns per page. The super important step, you have to do all the page setup things first, rows to repeat at top, margins, header, footer, and then just types of numbers, one through whatever. I use the fill handle with Ctrl. Go to print preview, how many rows per page, switch over to Alt F11, insert a module, and then type the code that I showed you in the video, click Run. And most of the time I advise people to save your workbook as XLSM, but in this case, this was a one-time thing, I'm suspecting. So if you're, you know, just want to have that macro disappear, keep it as XLSX. Save the file, it'll warn you that you're about to lose your macro, and that's probably okay because we've solved the problem. Well, hey, I want to thank Gwen for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.